So Consumer Reports, I told you, had earlier done this survey of CAM users and found high levels of satisfaction. And their conclusion about this was that the survey respondents seemed to like hands-on treatments, which included chiropractic and massage therapy and acupuncture and conventional physical therapy. And they thought that the healing power of touch might be a common thread among those kinds of treatments that was something that patients really appreciated. So my quick summary is this. I think that you should remember the most common CAM treatments for back pain are these three: chiropractic, acupuncture, and massage. Randomized trials of all three suggest that they yield better short-term pain relief than usual care. But it's ambiguous, I think, still, whether their results are better than a convincing placebo. But I've come to the view that maybe that ambiguity is okay, and maybe we can live with that ambiguity. The effects on actual disability are likely relatively small. Serious side effects can happen with these treatments, but happily they're very rare. And at least from our analysis of the MEPS, even if they're not cost-saving, there's certainly no evidence that these things would actually add to healthcare costs. So my sense of the clinical implications is that we have treatments that you might argue are no better than conventional medical care, although in fact they do seem to be a little better than usual care, certainly not worse. The mechanism by which they work may be ambiguous. It may be mostly placebo effect, but of course, much of what we do in conventional medical care is placebo effect as well. So the mechanism may remain ambiguous. These treatments are probably safer than much of what we do in conventional care. The healing power of touch, I think, may be an important and useful aspect of these treatments. There, I think it's fair to say, is growing acceptance by mainstream medicine of many of these things. And I'd argue that they're a reasonable choice for interested patients who have nonspecific low back pain. On the other hand, their benefits are probably relatively short acting, and more durable benefits may require other types of more long-term intervention and things that we hope result in more stable long-term benefits. And my favorite candidates there are exercise and cognitive behavioral therapy, which again have some growing evidence base behind them. Thanks very much.